Hey everyone, Wanderbot here, and today I'm going to be trying something a little bit new. I'm starting a new thing called Wanderbot Goes Rogue, where I play various roguelikes. So this one, today, is going to be Tower of Guns. Now, I've played a grand total of maybe 5 minutes of it, and I'm kind of terrible, but that's kind of the point of roguelike games. You suck when you start. So Tower of Guns is an indie game made by like Epic Games, or I forget the name. It's made by Joe Mirabello, and it's pretty much a one-man project to make a first-person shooter roguelike game. So let's just hop right in. So currently there are 10 guns in the game. You only have access to 2 of them. And you also have access to 2 abilities, and you can unlock more perks as you go along. So I'm going to go with Take No Fall Damage and the Portable Pizza Thrower, which fires saw blades, not pizzas. Probably for the best, I don't think I do much damage with pizzas. So this game is awesome. It's a solo project. You don't get to see a whole lot of solo projects with this level of, like, interesting polish. Also, interestingly, every time you start a new round, they have a couple different special things that the kind of NPCs say. Unfortunately, I was too busy running my mouth to actually notice what they were actually saying, so I'll just leave it up to you guys to tell me what they said, or just read it the next time around. So this game controls very classically first-person shooter, WASD controls. I think you can play it with a controller as well, but I'm not going to because my aim sucks with a, you know, twin-stick shooter type deal. So in this game you can also... Oh, you can't. So one of the powers available to you at start is triple jump. And I assume you can unlock double jump somewhere because currently all I can do is single jump, which not a problem. Especially because I don't take falling damage no matter how far I fall. Which is convenient, but the last time I tried this out, I was going around with triple jump, which is awesome. You can pretty much fly your way across the map. Problem is, then you fall to your death, and you take a lot of damage. And there's no, you know, easy way to heal in this game, so I find it's significantly easier to just turn on no fall damage until I've gotten a little bit... Holy balls. Balls. Ah. Okay, so there are a lot of different enemies. Most of them look to be a lot of, like, standard stationary turrets, which is fine and kind of cool, honestly. But most of them shoot giant-ass projectiles at you that move fairly slowly, but are kind of hard to avoid. Let's see. I don't think I should go down there. Well, that's actually really pretty. I've never really looked up before. So, unlike most roguelikes, in this one, you're going up constantly. But really, you barely notice. So, let's just keep going up. And I don't know if you have to shoot the doors to get through, but I've played enough Metroid to think that I'm supposed to. Oh boy, that's a lot of crap. That is a lot of crap. So, can I break the spikies? No, I cannot break these spikies. That is concerning. There are also these guys that fly at you and explode. And bullets are flying everywhere, and I guess I'll just switch. Oh, that's what's shooting all the bullets. Looks like a tougher than usual enemy, but what I have to worry about most are the flying enemies, because they can come around this. Whereas the giant gun enemy kind of only vaguely knows where I am, and I can switch between one side and another to shoot at him, but it's kind of risky business. Shoot, my health pickups are going away. Whatever the red orbs are, I've never really figured that one out. Oh, I broke it. I don't know what else is here. So it does look... Oh, there's another one. But this one doesn't look like it's the same super powerful version, but there are more things shooting spiky balls at me. Why is there so much stuff shooting at me? This is the Tower of Guns, damn it. What did I expect? I can hit them from up there. So the cool thing about the pizza thrower is that the quote-unquote pizzas do actually bounce. Oh, did I break them? Sweet. So the pizzas actually bounce around, so you can kind of do ricochet shots. Not saying that that's particularly useful, but if I see, like, there, maybe I can bounce them off of things. I don't know. Mostly I'm just running around trying to dodge as many projectiles as possible. I do not know how I didn't get hit there, and apparently I'm full health, so I must have picked up some health pickups. So it does... Oh, wait. If I aim at that, maybe I can get them to bounce down? Yeah. So the ricochet shot is actually a lot more useful than I was giving it credit for. I think I can... Whoa! Yeah, there are giant pizza throwers that also bounce, so I have to be concerned about that. But mostly it's the flying enemies that are the problem. Because, I mean, you can dodge them, but they're the ones that are going to follow you unerringly for a while. Oh, it looks like there's an enemy that shoots them out. So I'm going to actually have to get up there and deal with it instead of just sitting around like a complacent fool. Ooh, money. So there is a money system in this game. There's also a power-up system in this game. If you've ever played Cave Story, on the right side of my screen is the blue bar. As that charges up, it will rank up my gun from level 1 to level 2, which then... Oh, balls. Don't explode my face. Okay, good. So it will level up from 1 to 2 and give me, you know, increased power and damage. Holy crap, that does a lot of damage. And apparently I have a new perk available for taking all that damage, which is nice, I guess. I was kind of hoping to not take that damage, but I took one of the souped up saw blades to the face, and well, suffice to say, my face did not appreciate it. So I don't think I'm gonna live past this room. I think I got kind of a very short end of a stick. Oh, yeah, you can't look away for a second. The enemies will take advantage of that. But so I think I got the short end of the stick with multiple souped up enemies. Why can't I get past that? Is there something in the way? I think there's something in the way. Oh, it's this like weird screw looking thing that's knocking me off. But unfortunately the saw blade enemies, come on, go up. Go. What are you doing? Yeah, I am getting stuck on some of the in-game architecture, which is a little frustrating. This game is still, I believe, in either beta or alpha. Holy crap, this is scary looking. There are a lot of saw blades flying, and I think this is the only enemy left to me. Wait, can I bounce them off? No, it doesn't look like it. I'm gonna have to brave the... Oh, I can get it, and it can't get me. Good! I think I got it. I don't think there are any other enemies in here. At least until I, like, go further up. But, if you notice, I'm at so low health, I'm probably going to die the moment I run into anything new, because it's gonna get the jump on me, and I'm going to explode into a pile of very, very sad Wanderbot. So, where am I? What am I doing here? So, there is another gun available. I kind of pointed at it when we were just starting, and it's kind of this, like, weird pea shooter gun. I don't think I'm gonna want to go into it. What's this? Well, it wants 58 coins, and it's Rest in Peace plus plus badge. We'll see what that does. Well, I'm a moron. I just upped the difficulty on myself. Right in front of the boss room, too. Well, you know what? I'm almost dead. I'm gonna brave going up these stairs just to see what's up here. But if there's an enemy or any... Nope, it's just money. And a thing. Nope. I found a secret. I didn't get the... Okay. So, I'm stuck. I don't exactly know what that thing's supposed to be. But, that was a secret. And it was also a health pickup that I stupidly missed. So I'm gonna try and go back to that. And I don't know what the secret does, and I'm gonna probably look it up and feel incredibly foolish for just, you know, teleporting away. Let's see if we can... Health pickup... Yes, got it! It barely helped me in the slightest. Oh, okay. So if I jump through it, it will launch me out of one of the holes, I think. Or not, out of... Come on. What are we doing here? Get me out of... Okay. Well, luckily in this game, if you do get stuck, which there's the possibility of it, I used this earlier, but you can press the C button, which is called Tilt for some mysterious reason, but Tilt will teleport you back to the beginning of the room. It does take some time to charge up, and you can't move while doing it, or shoot, or you can shoot, but pretty much it's not kind of a, like, get out of jail free card. You pretty much have to use it when you're safe, otherwise you're in trouble. So, speaking of, I'm in trouble, and I can't use it to get out of this situation, so let's go see what this boss looks like and die terribly, shall we? Onwards! Oh crap, that's a thing. And I assume it's just going to shoot fiery doom that explodes all around, so I'm just going to have to... Oh, great. So, don't go in the orange circles. I'm going to have to spend a lot of time avoiding them instead. But I... Oh, great, and he summons enemies too. I'm not going to make it out of here alive. Yep, there we go. That was the end for Wanderbot. So, that is my second run of Tower of Guns. I really dig this game. It's got a really good soundtrack. The gameplay is tight. The guns, I kind of wish there were more guns, honestly. But, I mean, here are... Oh! I have the Constellation Charger. We'll have to try that out next. Same thing with Major Moose. So I'm just going to start this and talk while I go. But this is kind of more of a first impressions thing. I don't even know what I'm doing here. I'm just going to keep doing these until I hit like the 15-20 minute mark. So let's see how far I can go with this one. So what's this gun do? So it's like a spread launcher. Does it have an alternate fire? So it's got like maybe a slow fire and a fast fire? I don't even know. So the perk I picked up, which I'm probably not going to ever use again, it's called Major Moose, but it makes you slow and armored. So... what the hell kind of gun is this? Doesn't even do damage. Like, I'm just sitting here piling bullets into these things, and... I mean, I guess if I get really close, this is not going to be a very long run at all. But... it is definitely interesting, and maybe it just charges up really fast. So as soon as I get up to like rank 2, it'll be insane. Hopefully. Because I'm on the first room and it's already onto rank 2. Which is either I was doing terribly on the previous round, or, oi, those are, why are things exploding? There are all sorts of these little guys. Get out of here. Oh no, my gun is not powerful enough to fight them. And I got stuck on the architecture. Okay, let's see if I can... But I think... Okay, good. The little guys are not coming back. It's just these weird bouncing Betty gun launcher things. Okay, so it does do enough damage to the turrets, which I can deal with, but... yeah. So, one other thing that I really dig about this game, and it's kind of a complaint I have about first-person shooters, even though I know it's realistic, I hate the fact that in a lot of games you have limited ammunition. I know it's supposed to make you, like... play conservatively and not just like shoot your gun constantly, but you know what, when it comes down to it, either there's going to be enough ammo pickups to the point where it's pointless to even have a limited ammo setup, or you have so little ammo you more or less have to consistently pick up new weapons. Oh boy, I can't even hit these guys and they're going to explode in my face. So let's see if I can get a pickup. At least with these guys, they will stop to explode, so I can pretty much just strafe around them. Which is definitely good for good gameplay. Looks like my health has gone back up. So, I'm getting there with the power. But, yeah, just kind of the complaining about ammo thing. I know it kind of does make for more realistic gameplay and yada yada yada. But, like, when I'm playing on my own, I will admit, I tend to turn on unlimited ammo just because I'm lazy. Wow, there are a lot of enemies that just want to hug my face with their ripper saws. Oh boy. So, I can't tell if these guys are like ripper saws or they got spikes on the bottom, because they don't seem to want to like attack me in a lateral fashion. They only seem to want to land on my face. Well, looks like some more saw blade things. Let's see if I can get up here. Okay, I got the saw blade. They're the concern, because the cannon ones can't fire over the lip. And also, they fire a lot slower, so I can kind of strafe back and forth and fudge their shots. Looks like there's an explodey enemy that kind of wants to take me out. So I'm just going to kind of take pot shots at it until it gets close enough that I can hit it. It's not like I seem to have any sort of killing power. What hit me? I have no idea. Maybe nothing hit me. Oh, great. Another boss room. Just what I wanted. So, one other thing I've noticed about this game is there's no map, which is kind of weird. And it's not the end of the world, but I could definitely do with a map. Oh, right, I'm the moose. I don't have... I actually do take fall damage, which is a concern. But Binding of Isaac, for example, you have the little map on the side. Dungeons of Dreadmoor... Oh, boy, that... Oh, it didn't hurt me. Okay, Dungeons of Dreadmoor, you have, you know, the little map that you pretty much go through the level, so you always know where you are. And luckily, none of the levels seem to be particularly hard to navigate in this game. But it also seems like there's very little in terms of, like, branching path. Pretty much, it's just go to room A, go to room B, go to room C. What is that over there? Oh, it's a healer machine. So maybe if I How do I even get over there? I guess I go up this ramp and hope for the best. Oh, I didn't take fall damage for that. Let's see if I can get over there. Yes, okay. So, I guess I'm already full health. Oh, maybe this is a health up badge. Yes, max health plus plus. So that should help me out. But I'm still not banking on her survival. Oh, and that's kind of neat. Instead of extending the health bar, it just gives me a little, like, tacked on pip. Which is sweet. But I do not want to attempt the boss until I have a level 2 gun. So I'm going to try going down here into the mysterious depths. So I was talking about the lack of branching gameplay. And maybe this will be a new area entirely? No. No, it is a item that I cannot afford because I am dirt poor. Because I have not played enough rooms. So pretty much at this point I am forced to go fight the boss with very little preparation and a shitty ass gun. Because I take damage and my gun... I think I mentioned this earlier, but I might as well just reiterate it. Your gun will de-level when you take damage. So if you're playing stupid like I am, you're kind of punished for it in more ways than just dying. Which, it's not the end of the world, but it's kind of frustrating when you're just getting into it. But again, this is a roguelike. You should be used to it. This is a different boss. So what kind of unique mechanic is this? Bouncy balls and saw blades. Good to know. I actually seem to be doing a fair amount of damage. All of my shotgun hits seem to be hitting him. The one problem is you do get kind of tunnel vision, and luckily a lot of the projectiles are tiny. Oh, a lot of explodey enemies. Something to be concerned about. But Mama Spinbot seems to be going down pretty fast, so I can maybe take her out. Wow, yeah, she's starting to flash like crazy. So I don't know how many bosses there are in this game. I think at this point I'm just going to pump the shots and hope for the best and get out of there before the enemies explode on me. Oh, wow. That worked pretty well. Level 2 weapon. Got an item. I think Saint Attila's Fire. Interesting. So, one complaint I do have also is the power-ups will disappear. If you notice, there went a lot of them. Which, not all of them do. The more, like, established ones don't. But when the boss exploded there, I got all sorts of goodies that went away before I could even have the chance to get them all, because there's no sprint button. Interesting. Apparently you can use control to jump as well. Wonder what kind of control scheme he thought of there. Either way. So this is an elevator up. Now, I don't have enough money to get that thing. I've got like 78 gold, coins, whatever. So I can't go back and get that rocket thing. I don't even know if I can go back. I think I might be stuck in here. Yep. So I guess the only way is up. Let's take the elevator. Hope for the best. I actually did pretty well there, all things considered. Found no secrets, though. And I don't even know if there were supposed to be secrets. It should tell you if there are secrets or not after the fact, but I guess at the same time, whoops. Also, stage par is half the time I did, so clearly I'm not doing that great. But I'm not dead yet, and I'm full health, and I got a level 2 gun, so I'm not complaining. Okay, so where am I? Pretty much the same thing. So, the NPCs are chattering. This is the foundry, and the robot guy apparently was made here. So, also, I picked up Saint Attila's Fire, which I mentioned by name, but EDUs, and it's got 4 charges or something like that. So either I've got 4 uses on it, and they recharge, or just 4 uses, period. Or, ooh, these are new enemies. But they seem to be going down a lot faster than previous times, so I think I might be okay. I'm not really... Get out of here. Get out of here. This is my tower. Stop shooting me. Okay. This is scary business. Okay. So I'm still full health. That's pretty good. The enemies that were flying around and shooting me was a little concerning. I don't know if there's much over here, but there's a ramp down, so maybe there's some loot. Which would be nice, because I didn't really get a whole lot from those enemies. I see nothing. Oh, I see a thing. All the way over there. Let's see if I can go peer at it from up above. But I get the feeling it's going to be... Oh, it's one of those health things. Well, that's useless. I'm full health. But... And it's not even... Oh, great. So we've got a couple of flyers that will shoot at me. A bunch of... Oh, great. Now I'm... Oh, I had a level 3 gun for a bit there. So I got these big flyer guys and a bunch of gun turrets along the sides that are more or less just firing infinite salvos at me. So let's see if I can dodge those bullets. Wow, I actually did fairly well. Okay, now I'm more or less free to just deal with the side things. Unfortunately, the scatter gun... You can't shoot bullets out of the sky, which would be really convenient about now because my shotgun is all kinds of worthless. I don't even see the way. Oh, I go down. Okay, so instead of trying to tango with them that way, I'm going to cross this, hope for the best, hope they don't hit me, and I really hope nothing else shows up to... tits. Well, luckily a shotgun does crazy amounts of damage close up, so I can just kind of strafe around these enemies. I'm still pretty high on health, which is good. And my gun is level 2. I guess it had made it up to level 3 after the boss, which is good. Oh, back up to level 3. So they're still shooting at me, but with any luck, I can... Oh, dang it. Okay, there's one of those big guys that shoots a lot of bullets. I guess the scatter gun really is doing pretty well. Even though it's really annoying to aim. Okay. So I'm gonna take this opportunity to fire off. That was worthless. So apparently you have one charge of Saint Attila's fire before it runs out. But I assume either killing enemies or clearing a room is going to get you your charges back. So I'm just gonna take these guys head on and just kind of strafe their shots, because I think that's probably going to be the safest, and they turn around so slowly it's pointless. And then I guess I can use one of those things to shoot myself across onto the other side of the room. But I'm going to brave the bullets. Oh, damn, there's something hitting me. Oh, there's a big enemy back there. Oh, and looks like most of the goodies went away. Great. Oh, but I can take this pipe across? Maybe. Looks like it. I think I can move fast enough that their bullets aren't going to be a problem. And yep, it looks like Saint Attila's fire recharges based on... Holy crap. Do not go through that thing unless you're ready to be launched across the room. Okay. Good to know. But Saint Attila's fire will recharge based on my kills. So if I'm getting a lot of kills, I should be able to get all my charges back. And I'm full health. Nice. Well, that was pointless. Well, let's get back across and go back with the killing. So, in this run, I'm actually doing surprisingly well. I'm doing a lot better than I did the last round, which is weird because I don't like this gun that much. This gun is inaccurate at very long range, does a lot of damage, which is mainly why I'm doing so well, and a lot of the enemies have been easy to dodge, which is good. I do have a health upgrade, and my weapon is level 3, so I'm not hurting, but I'm definitely just a little apprehensive because this game is not easy. So, first order of business for this room, dodge the bullets. Second order, take out the flyer, he's the most concerning. Then the turrets, which turn very slowly, can be just strafed around and taken out with no problem. Oh, looks like spiky launchers. They're concerning because they bounce, they roll, and there are a lot of them. And I have no idea what these things are. Maybe it powers up my shots? But that's a concern I don't want to deal with. What the hell happened there? Okay. So, what I think I can do... Oh! I see. Certain ones of these make me go faster. But what I can do is just kind of hang out below where they can't hit me. Because... Are they moving up or down? Oh, this is weird optical illusion. Blaptical. Blah, blah, blah. That's a lot of things. Well, let's brave whatever this is. Okay, so apparently it just does fire damage to me. So... What have we learned? Don't go through the thing. Nice to know. I guess it's got kind of a fire animation. But considering it's the exact same color as the speed booster thing, yeah, apparently it won't let me go down unless I jump really awkwardly, which I guess makes sense. But if you've ever tried running down an escalator, or up, kind of depending on what direction it's going, you can go up or down an escalator. Whereas these just do not want me to go. Well, let's just go the path of least resistance and head back up, because I don't think there's anything else in this room for me. So, what is in here? This is big. Oh, so it's a bunch of, oh It's a bunch of things. Oh, and these guys shoot out the little spheres of death. Oh, I'm in a very tight spot here. Oh, clear on some space over here. Hopefully, I should take that guy out first. So I've managed to take out two of the hopping pots, which is good. I made that name up. Don't quote me on what their actual name is. I have no idea what half of this stuff does. I don't know what the red orbs do, or really any of the power-ups. It would be kind of nice if they're uniform, or at least explained, because the like solid-edged ones are definitely maybe more powerful, but like the blue ones power up your weapon, the red ones heal you, but they're like coin-looking health things that I know heal me, but the red orbs maybe heal me too? It's kind of inconsistent. I wish it wasn't, but that's kind of a... Holy crap. What am I even dealing with here? So, it looks to be a rapid fire thing and a impassable area of just pure death. So I think I might have to go for a swim in the lava, which is not an ideal solution. Unless... Oh, yeah, I can hit them. I can hit them from here. I don't... let's make sure there's nothing shooting at me. I might as well pick up the health pickup. But they kind of can shoot at me, but it looks like they have a limited range defined by that big yellow area. So I'm just going to fire my scattergun constantly straight up until I have managed to either take them out or I get very tired. But they look to be taking damage, and they're starting to flash rapidly, so they're dying. They got to be dying. Yep. Okay, so that's two of them. Unfortunately, the scattergun has all of the aiming ability of a gopher strapped to a firework, so this might take a little while. So, while we wait for my clicking finger to get tired, and me to whack the microphone with my water bottle, apologies, I'm gonna take a drink. I feel like I should have coffee or some sort of special beverage, but no, I just have day-old water because I am a classy individual. Uh-oh. So, while I do this, I might as well kind of talk about the state of the game. So this game is, it's been greenlit at this point, so if you're only interested in games that are on Steam, this is perfect. You don't have to worry about it in that regard. This game is still in either alpha or beta. When I loaded the game up, it said thank you for buying the alpha version. So, I'm more than willing to bet that this is... Well, I've cleared out an entire side, so I'm going to... Okay, cool, you can float across. Which is much more useful than swimming through the lava. And it's also safe, so I can kind of float up closer to these things and not have to worry about it. But I do have to worry about, you know, falling on my face or missing pickups on the way down. So let's see if we missed anything the entire way. Doesn't look like it. So let's get up here and take these things out for real. And make sure nothing else is shooting at me. Doesn't look like it, so let's just kill this thing casually, because currently we're just bouncing around the top. So yeah, this game is in alpha and or beta, either or. It's in a pretty good state. And question mark badge. I'm okay with this. I have money. Mystery box, what do you have in store for me? Blue XP rate minus minus. Ah, shit. So pretty much that spells doom for my ability to level this gun up any more than it is, and since I can't guarantee I'm going to get anything else, I'm just going to have to trust in my ability to not die. Oh jeez, that's a lot of spikes, I should avoid that. So, alpha or beta, this game feels incredibly well polished already. I've only had it crash once on me after I finished a level. Oh, boss battle. So, why don't we get into this and I'll keep talking about it, but... You know, alpha or beta, oh jeez, I do a lot of damage. With any luck, I might actually be able to do fine here. So, there's one, there's two? I'm just gonna tank this, he doesn't seem to be doing enough damage to me. Unfortunately, it is taking out, like, most of my experience, which is a problem. But, I managed to pretty much just chow through his health with no issue. And let's try and pick up all the pickups before they all go away. Even though I think they're all gonna go poof fairly fast. So, the little red orbs do in fact heal you. Okay, so I've lost Saint Attila's fire, and now I have caffeinated trigger finger, which I'm assuming makes me shoot faster. So, this game feels incredibly polished. I've seen three different bosses in the half hour I have played this now, and You know what? That's pretty good. It's not Binding of Isaac level. I don't know if it'll ever get that far. But if it does, I will be thankful, because this game is a lot of fun. I mean, it's really pretty, too. Like, it's got this really nice steampunky industrial feel, kind of in the same vein as Borderlands, but with, I guess, a little bit more barren, but a lot less just, like, dust and brown. What the hell was that? I just heard, like, a muffled scream and a crash. Okay. You guys heard that, right? I hope you did. New perk, Fire Force. I don't know what that means. I'm even worse on par. But, you know what? I don't care. I'm surviving. I'm still mostly full health. Unfortunately, I have a downgrade on my weapon experience, and I just lost a lot tanking the boss. So we'll see. Now, so if you're looking to pick up this game, I'd say just pick it up now. The developer deserves as much money as he can get, because this game is awesome. As far as like features he's adding, I have no idea. I haven't even looked at what he wants to do with this game. And if he had told me that this is a completed game, I would have looked at him and said, yeah, you know, looks pretty good to me. Which is super encouraging if it's still only in alpha. Like I said, very few bugs, a lot of game features. This is pretty good, all things considered. I'm going to try and get the power-ups before they go way up. But the bouncing Bettys are going to bounce me. Let's keep scooting around. I guess the downgrade on the weapon experience isn't terrible, because I'm already halfway to level 4, which is good. So, I guess the penalties aren't particularly major, but that could also imply that, like, if I ever pick up a boost, it's not going to be particularly great either. Which, tolerable. So, I think the orbs are the things that go away, and the things that look more like coins stick around. I don't know what the yellow ones do. Oh, those are powers for my items, of course. This game is starting to make more sense. Oh, never mind. I guess the things that do have borders go away. Except for health pickups? It's weird and inconvenient and hard to understand. So I don't think there's anything to go through here. That's cool. You can keep seeing up the Tower of Guns. So, I don't think this is an endless game, but it is definitely randomly generated. So every time you go through a run, it will be new. Oh, great. My old friends, the saw blade machines that I love so dearly. Well, let's clear them out. Okay, so I'm safe for the moment. Let's get around here. Oh, another bouncing Betty and a purple machine that I don't recognize, which is more than a little concerning. Let's strafe around it and see if I can... Oh, it fires very slow homing orbs that explode. And then there's that guy. So let's get our ill-gained reward and just kind of strafe around these things. At this point, I've cleared out most of the enemies that are concerning. It's just... You know, your standard row of cannons, and that's it. I hope there's nothing around this corner that's going to kill me, but realistically, fighting these guys is not a concern. That is a concern. That is a huge concern. It's a fast-moving enemy that shoots 6 shots that move fairly fast. Great. Oh, boy. Okay. I actually tilted my head there to dodge. I should probably stop doing that. I blame flying. Oh, and there's an item up there, and I'm never going to be able to get it because I don't have triple jump. Sucks. Okay, so yeah. I guess, as far as things that I wish this game had, I really wish that you could actually pick up guns as you went along instead of having one gun to start with and just stick with it. But that's not that big of a deal. I don't know how I dodged all of those. But, like, I like this shotgun. It's nice, and it definitely means that, you know, next round I'm going to be super excited to have... You know, the pizza launcher again, probably, even though I apparently suck with it in comparison. So is there no way I can get to whatever this is? It's fuzzy. Oh, it's a speed boost. That would be really useful, actually. Oh, what's this? Is the door broken? Maybe. And I don't think anything's behind there, so let's try and go through the broken door. Well... maybe it's just something special? Or... Okay, so the floor is... scary. Everything about this is scary. I'm going to just run as far away from this as possible because it looks like death. And I'm losing a lot of health and weapon experience, and there are tower things shooting at me, and I probably shouldn't have been just strafing backwards without looking where I was going. But the alternative looks even worse than this. There's just mayhem and purple shit everywhere. So, geez, and they have, like, unlimited range, and I don't have any kind of range whatsoever. So let's... Oh, there's still one of the bouncing pots. I should take that out. So let's see what this does. Okay, so this just increases my shot speed, which is good, because I don't want to fight any more bouncing pots or the purple guys. Up, and it looks like my thing has run out. So they're almost dead, which is going to help immensely, because those purple things are starting to get on my nerves. I'm also starting to get very low on health, and I'm actually almost back down to level 2 weapon. Can I just get out of here? Yeah, I can. Why am I sticking around if I'm just going to slowly die on those enemies? Oh, this is a boss room. Wonderful! I probably should have looked before I leaped, but I think I had already shot the door, so I wouldn't have known. So, here looks like he's got several different types of things. The bottom is a thumper, which I don't think I can avoid. I think it just does consistent damage to me. And then the top one shoots bullets, and then I don't even know what's above that. Probably more bullets, but it looks like I'm going to die here. I don't do enough damage. Oh, and I'm back down to level 2. Yeah, obviously I'm not going to do enough damage. And you know what? I had a great run. That was actually amazing as far as like my second or third run. Third run. Because my first run, I died fairly pathetically right away. So, all in all, I thought that was a fairly successful run for kind of my first introduction to the Tower of Guns. I hope to make it further, and I'm probably going to do a fair number more of these because this game's entertaining. It's very tightly controlled, and it's got really good music, too. I really appreciate that. So, just kind of as a recap slash just shameless plugging for this game, it's good. If you like first-person shooters, if you like roguelikes, and if you, like, were, Paranautical Activity is kind of similar from what I've heard. I've never picked it up myself, but if you're interested in that sort of thing, definitely pick this up. I think it's about $10, actually, which, especially at $10, is incredibly reasonable, though it goes on sale fairly frequently. They had a Alpha Fun bundle a while back, or not bundle, but it was just like a Greenlight sale, where they had games that were still either not on Greenlight or stuck in the Greenlight process to try and promote it. Or currently, I think Indie Game Stand actually has a Pay What You Want version of this. So, I would highly recommend picking it up. If you pay, you know, $1, you'll get the Steam key when it comes along. If you pay, like, $2, you get the soundtrack and art book. And, like, it just keeps going up from there. But if you're really interested in, you know, roguelike first-person shooters, whatever, this game is perfect. Try it out. You're gonna sink a lot of time into it. It's a roguelike, which, you know, on a cost-per-value thing is great. And really, it's just a fun game. And, you know, I'm gonna be playing it a lot more. So, with that, I will see you guys on the next episode of Wanderbot Goes Rogue, which is either going to be another run of Tower of Guns, or I'm probably gonna switch to either Binding of Isaac or Dungeons of Dreadmore, kind of depending on what I'm feeling like. I'm probably just going to alternate between all of the various roguelikes I've picked up over the years, and, you know, pretty much just throw up the entire uncut footage for you every Monday. So, I will see you guys then. Wanderbot out.